major victory for Colin Kaepernick after his anti-Trump attorney just released infuriating announcement. The NFL sinks like the Titanic running into an iceberg of social justice, and Colin Kaepernick is the captain driving the sinking ship into a destiny of doom, gloom, and low ratings. While the NFL protesting players continues to ruin the beloved entertainment known as American football, the sinking ship keeps filling with the water of the annoying leftist views. Disrespecting the flag, raising black power fists, and doing everything they can to sink their own career and million-dollar salaries is what the passenger players of the NFL ship are doing, and it might get a little bit worse. If this happens, then the NFL could inevitably have the worst year ever. Colin Kaepernick has been dealing with the grievance he filed against the NFL in regards to collusion to keep him out of the league. His anti-Trump attorney, Mark Geragos, just gave an update that I believe many people will dislike. Everyone from fans, players, coaches, and team owners could potentially dislike what Geragos said. "I think within the next 10 days somebody will sign him," Geragos said during a recent appearance on the Adam Carolla show. "I think somebody's gonna sign him. I think the NFL has to come to their senses, and realize every day that goes by just proves the collusion case even more." No further details were provided, however. Are you kidding me? What team wants Kaepernick? I can't think of any team, good or not, who would want to sign the one player who is most likely responsible for the sinking ratings, the possible loss of millions, and an overall upset nation of football fans who feel disrespected for the protest of the American flag. I don't think the worst NFL teams would want Kaepernick. The Cleveland Browns and San Francisco 49ers are winless at 0-8 records, so they're already having the worst year possible. Adding Kaepernick to their team could essentially make their fans not ever show up to another game. I think the fans would hate it if their owner added Colin Kaepernick to the roster. It has to be heartbreaking for any of the hardcore 49ers and Browns fans still showing up to games on a weekly basis knowing their team is likely going to lose. Imagine how those fans will feel if their team signs a protesting disrespectful player like Kaepernick. Do you think they would embrace that or be annoyed and finally stop showing up for games? Kaepernick's attorney speaks to CNN about a smoking gun. "I am going to predict right now that we will have a smoking gun," attorney Mark Geragos explained to CNN's Anderson Cooper Tuesday on AC 360 about the case resulting from Kaepernick's kneeling protest against the treatment of blacks, particularly by law enforcement. "There are people who are not going to get into an arbitration proceeding and they are not going to lie. They are not going to lie. They are going to tell the truth and they're going to say what happened. They were told no, you're not going to hire him." I disagree with the attorney. I think owners just don't want to alienate or disrespect their fans by hiring the Kim Kardashian of football. Kaepernick isn't as good as he was the year he went to the Super Bowl. His stats have declined, and he's not that elite passer that most teams search for. He isn't the guy who will throw for 3,500 yards in a season, and since he's a few years older, his running game may have declined from what made him a slightly more dynamic quarterback in his early career. He's no Mike Vick, that's for sure. Geragos might think that owners will say they've all colluded, but I think owners in general just don't like Kaepernick enough to risk it. Now the truth should be told that Kaepernick is better than some of the second-string players out there. Some backup quarterbacks are just terrible and Kaepernick is probably better than them. In fact, I'm going to say he is 100% better than at least a handful of backup quarterbacks. However, no smart businessman will ever pay top-tier money for second-string talent. No smart businessman will hire the one player who a majority of the fans dislike. Football is an entertainment business. It's not about the game, it's about putting on a show and making millions every weekend. A smart owner is not going to take his customers' money and buy the one player that a large portion of fans likely dislike. I like cheeseburgers, and if I give my money to someone at a food place and they give me a tofu burger in return, then I'm going to be very annoyed and not come back. Will Kaepernick get signed to a team in 10 days? Will he get signed at all? I don't see why any team would want him. It's not about color or talent, but it's the fact that he's annoying and fans dislike him. That's a good enough reason not to hire someone and pay them millions. Why take the fans' hard-earned money and give it to the player they probably don't ever want on their team?